Hello everyone, this is Gurveen here. In this video, we will be having a look at the Swagger UI support in Mocky. So as part of the Learn Mocky series, we have seen in the earlier sessions how Mocky provides us a very good out-of-the-box support for REST API development, using which we can define our own resource paths in the service REST API XML files and define our own REST API endpoints as per our need in our custom components. So if you want to have a more look at the technical aspects of REST API support in Mocky, I would recommend to go through the session 5 of the playlist. But in this session, we will talk about another important aspect of APIs, which is the documentation part of it. Now, this is important as it tells us how to effectively use and integrate with an API. So it acts like a reference manual containing all the information which is required to work with an API. And how Mocky provides us this support is it gives the out-of-the-box support for Swagger UI. So if we have a look at the Mocky documentation in the website, under the Tools and Config overview, we have the description for the REST API support. And it is mentioned that in the Tools app, we have the Swagger UI, which will automatically generate the documentation. And this is produced by the framework based on the different REST XML files we have in the component and the entities and the services which we are using within it. So how this works is, let us see through an example. So let's see through the UI where the Swagger UI can be located. So if we log in to the application, we have the Tools menu, and we can see we have the REST API Swagger UI mentioned. And we can see a list of REST APIs mentioned under the REST API. Now, how this works is Mocky will look into the service directory for the component, and it will look for the .rest.xml files. And based on it, it will generate the REST API documentation. So for an example, let us refer the example component, which we have been using in our earlier sessions as well. So if I click on the example REST API, we can see that it has listed down the different resources. Now this is based on the resources which we have defined in the example REST XML file in the example component. We have the base URL and the API version. Now all this information is there in the file. So it will parse the XML file and it will generate the documentation which is needed. So let us have a look at the REST XML file in the IDE to have a better understanding of how this documentation is generated. So we have the example REST XML file under the service directory. We can see we have two root resources. So we have examples and the example features, because of which we were seeing the two resources listed in the UI. Then we have different other endpoints under these two resources. So let us have a look at a get and a post example. So we have a get on the examples, which is an entity operation, which will list down the example records for us. And we have a post API defined, which will help us in creating an example. And the service is defined in the example services XML file. So if I go to the example services XML file, so we have a create example service. So I have changed it a little bit than what is available in the GitHub. So we can see that we have a display name for this example we can mention in this attribute. Then we can give a description which will tell us the intent of this REST API service, of what it is trying to do. So here it is trying to create a new example record in the system. Then we will be having some input parameters and the output parameters for which we would want some attributes to be mandatory. So we have certain required parameters here. Then we can give some description about the different parameters available. which will tell us what kind of data to expect while creating the records. Now, using this information, the Swagger UI can show us in the Mocky support of Swagger UI. So if I go back to the UI, let us expand the example resource. We can see all the REST API endpoints are listed with the different HTTP methods. And if we have a look at the create example, we can see that the description is available. Then we have the model schema for the response, which is the example ID of the type string. And if we have a look at the model for the out parameters, we can see that it has read the different descriptions available and it has listed it down under the model schema. Then we have the different request body parameters, and the parameters which we marked as required true, we can see that it has appeared in the bold. So we have example name, type, and status in the bold. Then the descriptions can be seen underneath the boxes. It is also available in the model for the request body. So we can also have a look at the different descriptions and if it is optional or it is mandatory in the model schema of the request body. And we can also see a sample schema which is generated to have a better look at the JSON request. So this was for the create example. If we have a look at the get example, so we have the list example available, which was an entity operation. So it is taking the schema from the entity, which is the example entity defined in the component. And since it is a list, what Mocky does is it will automatically provide us with few parameters for pagination and order by field, which we can use to do the get on the example records. And the other fields are available from the example entity. And if there is any description available, this will be listed under the description column. And then we have parameter type and the data types, which are defined as per the either the entity or we have a custom service wrapper, which we have written for the different REST API operations. Then if we have a look at example of we want to get one record, so we have that in the REST API file, which was for get an example by ID. So we have the ID mentioned here to get a particular record. Now, since this is an ID, so this becomes mandatory to perform this operation. So if we go back to the UI, we can see that we have the example ID parameter, which is required to perform this operation. Then we can also try it out. So if we give any example ID, so we can get the response here for the record which we have just requested. So with this, with minimal changes, we can make use of this out of the box support of Swagger UI in Mocky. And this really helps in when someone wants to consume the APIs, and it will help us in getting the in making the adoption of the APIs much easier. So this was all for the Swagger UI with Mocky. If there is any question, please feel free to comment. Thank you for watching.